真，是混了马上佛家不过我，只有你最默默的公文说，的公文说话落到笔呢，阿不阿祖那一些真是非乱动，
马上就有那里的真，是混了马上佛家不过我，只有你最默默的公文说，的公文说话落到笔呢。
Presence felt by the population, and it is also a pleasure that we have the religious
come to salvation. And ladies and gentlemen, the population
comes in order to have a listening ear. That which will cause development for all, that which what we want, especially in terms of economic activities, women and women's party. That is the score on which I am. To the differences. That needs special attention. And we are very hopeful that the breed of personalities we are going to install today will cause that change to happen. The microphone to my French counterpart that has to help its citizens to express themselves, that which we have to honor. We have come to signal this release and the ceremony of arms.
The man will send a decoration to show peace and care. That is the mayor elect. That is one of the guests of honor. The leader of the team is making his entrance into the country. He will last for long. He will soon be. After the reception, the national anthem will be sung by the choir of the White Supreme Party. They have already installed themselves comfortably out there. The national anthem, everybody should stand to pay tribute to that slot.
Let us remain standing.
The senior divisional officer, which is the highest authority, I'm sitting authority in the division.
We can be seated.
My speech to be handled by the elite of Wound. After all, it is the occasion of the mayor, and he too should be received by. Before I begin, that I am just a reader of an address presented by Senator Wallen David Akpo on behalf of the Wound elite on the occasion of the installation of the Mayor of the Wound Council, Lord Mayor, Comrade Grambong Anthony Mvo, today, November 30th, 2013, at the Wound Grandstand. The Senior Divisional Officer for Mentum Division, the Divisional Officer Wound Subdivision, the Lord Mayor, Wound Council, the President of the High Court, Mentum, and the Learned State Council, political and religious authorities, the Paramount Fund of Agam, Fons and Ardus, external and internal elite, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. Words, phrases, and pronouncements alone will not suffice to express the joy, son, husband, elite, as mayor of the Wound Council. Today is that day the Lord himself has made, a history-making day, a day where historians shall write and write again. Today marks a political revolution in the Wound Council as a young man for the first time in the history of the council, takes over command. When Pitt the Younger, one-time British Prime Minister, became Prime Minister at the age of 24, his detractors doubted his capability, describing him as a schoolboy in whose hands the destiny of a great nation like Britain has been handed. But Pitt the Younger became the best Prime Minister Britain has ever had. The Senior Divisional Officer, ladies and gentlemen, Chairman of the CPDM Party, for the confidence bestowed on Comrade Grambong Anthony Mvo, I vividly recall your election in the National Bureau of the YCPDM. Your selection by the party hierarchy in 2010 to represent the party at the World Festival of Youth and Students in Pretoria, South Africa, and above all, your coordination of the entire YCPDM in the Northwest region. Bear in mind, Mr. Lord Mayor, that by being the mayor of the Wound Council, you are the doyen of all the mayors of Mentum Division, where you will be privileged to receive His Excellency President Paul Biya in the months ahead to lay the foundation stone for the construction of a dam on the Mentum River. If you fail, the entire division has failed. And if you succeed, the entire division will succeed. But the caliber of the aid of whom congratulate and salute your brilliant election to the prestigious and enviable position of Mayor of Wound Council. The Senior Divisional Officer, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, as we all know, some leaders are born, some are made leaders, some achieve leadership. Mayor Grambong Anthony Mvo was born a leader. Your steady rise to leadership
can be traced as far back as in the late 80s. The role you played in the creation and management of the Agam Students Association, ASA, Menchum Students Union, the management of the Menchum Eagles Football Club, the creation of the physics family in ENS Bambili, your role in calming the tempers of women during a sit-down strike in 2003, the many structures that have received your philanthropic gestures. You have equally supported developmental projects in Rum and beyond. The youths of the subdivision are greatly indebted to you for promoting sporting activities through the organization of inter-quarter football competitions during holidays. You have equally supported prizes to teachers. You have equally supported destitute children in this subdivision through the award of scholarships, and your excellence award to teachers is worth mentioning. Through your political clairvoyance and savoir-faire, the Chantal Biya Foundation in September 2010 assisted orphans of Menchum Division with gifts and other school materials, not forgetting the donation of drugs to the Hume District Hospital and the St. Martin's Health Center. Your election as the YCPDM Section President for Menchum 1 in 2007 was a great booster to the party. This explains why the victories of the party in Hume in 2007, the senatorial elections in 2013, and the municipal and parliamentary elections of September 30, 2013 this year are greatly attributed to you. You spent your personal resources, time and the needed energy to ensure that the party wins the September 30th pre-elections. It is no longer a secret that many voters voting the CPDM list on September 30th, 2013 was not a mistake, but just a genuine decision to crown someone whose loyalty and stewardship to the party and his community is worth the salt. A role model. I call on the youths of Menchum Division to draw lessons from your election as the mayor of Wum Council. You can be the change that society wants. The senior divisional officer, ladies and gentlemen, Christian Cardinal Tumi, in one of his writings, wrote, "A chair does not make a man, but a man makes a chair." Mr. Lord Mayor is therefore a heavy one. You shall be expected to improve on the living conditions of the population of your municipality, maintain farm-to-market routes, provide portable drinking water, and promote economic and sporting and cultural activities. Work hand in glove with your supervisory authority. Traditional and cherished dream in Menchum Division is the reopening of the Home Area Development Authority, WADA. And now that you are in power, we shall in one accord certainly realize this dream. After all, St. Augustine of Hippo once wrote, "The only medicine for a miserable people is hope." The senior divisional officer, distinguished guests, let me refresh your memories with these inspiring words of Professor Victor Anomagu of Regrettable Memory. Do not speak when you are expected to keep silent, and do not be silent when you are expected to take action. Mr. Lord Mayor, may these words of wisdom be your guiding principle at the helm of the Home Council. You have always been a man of action, and action speaks louder than words. Make more use of your eyes than with your tongue. the senior divisional officer, ladies and gentlemen, today in whom we are not celebrating the victory of the CPDM party, nor the crowning of Gambon Antony, but the freedom of Metro Division in general, and hometown in particular, from underdevelopment. Today symbolizes the dawn of a new beginning. The old is gone, and everything has become new. The people of Wum have decided their fate by opting for a CPDM mayor. This, of course, is a social contract between the people of Wum and the president. I congratulate and welcome the elite in general who have sacrificed time and money to be part of this historic event. This elite class of Wum subdivision is a new breed, void of selfishness, hatred, and rancor. Hundreds of miles to dignify and magnify this august ceremony. We acknowledge the presence of all of you who are here, especially our friends beyond the division. Your presence here today is a mark of love, not only for the entire division. President John F. Kennedy once said, "Geography has given us neighbors, history has given us friends, economics has given us brothers. What God has put asunder or put together, let no one put asunder." While wishing you a happy stay in Wum, may God safely take you back to your various destinations. Long live Wum Subdivision, long live Menchum Division, long live President Paul Biya, long live Cameroon.
Interesting speech. One.
Hey youth!
Hey youth! How is it here? With peace and unity, justice and freedom, unity development for a better Wum Council.
Motivation from the mayor-elect that who has to be installed today.
With gratitude to the choir.
Remember to make
Honorable
Richard Ogbe.
His motivation to this youths of the party.
Are you a mayor? A man of few words. You are going to make a difference in the reign of mayors.
Lord Keller, the manager or proprietor of
Kodima Morin, the former mayor, Amen. We are praying for you.
Our brother Chosun Pen,
a politician, Mayor, we are praying for you.
The first deputy mayor, acknowledging the work carried out by this
week. This is you today at the womb grandstand. If you plant cocoyams, you harvest cocoyams. This is a cocoyam you have harvested today here.
Honorable Padiakwa.
The womb population here is looking up to you. For peace.
Principal GDDC home.
Unity.
To motivate the kids.
Love.
Not really kids in that sense, but the youth.
Employment. And development. Bravo.
I can see one madam there who are just going there to motivate the youths.
And by God's will, you grow higher. And mayor, we wish you the best.
That was the president of the Agam Women in Bamenda.
And by God's will, you grow higher. And mayor, we wish you the best.
Honorable Padiakwa, who has just also motivated the youths of the Supreme Party.
We wish you a happy mayorship. We wish you a happy mayorship.
Thank you, thank you, thank you, the youths of the Supreme Party. The Senior Division Officer of Prevention.
Own subdivision. The incoming mayor. First deputy and second deputy for Wound Council. Honorable Member of Parliament, the Head of Public and Private Services, leaders of legalized political parties, traditional rulers, religious authorities, internal and external elites, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, after the municipal election of the 13th September 2013, followed by the council session of the 16th August 2013, related to the election of the municipal executive, I am honored this day to preside over the official installation of the mayor, the first deputy, and the second deputy mayors of Wound Council. I would like, first of all, to thank the spokesmen of the elites of Wound Municipality of his warm and kind words of welcome extended to me, my entourage, and all the guests present here today. My gratitude also goes to the mayor and his collaborators, equally to the lively forces of this municipality for their contribution in making this ceremony a success. Ladies and gentlemen, solemn and official installations of mayors and their deputies are administrative procedures used in putting emphasis on the main role of the municipal executive at the head of the decentralized territorial collectivity called the Council. This ceremony is also an occasion to officially present to the public the newly elected mayor and his deputies to enable them to come in terms with the duties henceforth bestowed on them. For today's occasion, it is 0299 stroke A Minat stroke DCTS election of mayor Mr. Digambon Anthony Go. The first deputy, Mr. Hamza Umaru. And the second deputy, Madam Ako Ne Asho Fabiola Alima Etio, for whom concert. Dear population of Wurum Municipality, no doubt it is because of numerous qualities of the person that you voted as councillors, while thereafter elected as council executive. Ladies and gentlemen, the person who is going to take over the head of Wurum Council is no other person than Mr. Digambon Anthony Go, your new mayor. Born on the 17th of June 1970 at Adamu, he attended primary education in St. Martin's School and obtained the first school leaving certificate in 1982. He then proceeded for secondary education to GHS, Wurum, and Nacho High School, Bamenda, where he obtained GCA O-level and GCA A-level in 1991. After obtaining his GCE O-level, Mr. Digambon Anthony Go proceeded to higher education in the University of Yaoundé and ANS Bambili, where he obtained the DPS 1 in 1996. Upon graduation, he served as teacher from 1996 to date in GS Ako, GSS Tabenken, GHS Mundu, and GHS Mambu, respectively. He is married and the father of three children. That's it. Your first deputy mayor is Mr. Hamza Umaru. Born on the 5th December 1970 in Wurum.